Let me tell you an interesting true story. My uncle, my father's elder brother, used to work in Karachi, now in Pakistan. And he had a beautiful house on the Clifton Beach, a beautiful beach, and he was a meteorologist, weatherman. He used to study the weather, and he was a disciple of Great Master. And he invited Great Master to come to Karachi and stay in his house for a little break, for a vacation. And a group of us traveled with Great Master by train, and we reached there. Now, my uncle and my aunt, who were followers of the Great Master, also used to go to a Swamiji, Swami Brahmananji, who was very good in teaching different forms of yogic exercises, and also used to give Ayurvedic medicines. He was a very good Vaid also. So they did not go to him for understanding yoga or something. They were following Surat Shabd Yoga of the Great Master, but they used to go to him to get the Ayurvedic medicines. When they learned that Great Master is going to visit their house, they went to Swamiji and said, "Swami Brahmananji, our master is coming from Punjab, and we would be very happy to introduce you to him, because you would find him a very interesting person, and he'll talk of Surat Shabd Yoga to you." And Swamiji said, "Yes, bring him to us, bring him to me, I will bless him." They said, "We didn't plan that." So they had to then find some way to deal with the situation. So they decided they will have lunch in their house. A Great Master will be staying there, and we'll invite Swamiji also to lunch and put them on a love chair, on a love seat with two seats on the sofa, and put them together, they can meet each other. So that day came, and Swamiji arrived. He used to have beautiful eyes, wonderful person. And he used to wear an orange-colored, saffron-colored robes, and used to have a little muffler type of thing, which he used to hold like this with his hands, and walk like this with great pomp and show. He looked very nice when he walked. So Swamiji came like that, and they introduced him, put him on the sofa. Then Great Master was in the bedroom. They called him, and Great Master came, and they said, "Please sit down." And they said, "Master, this is the Swami Brahmananji we have been talking to you about, from whom we go and get our Ayurvedic medicines." And Great Master folded his hand and saluted like this, Swamiji, and Swamiji raised his hand on his head and said, "I bless you." We were all watching. I have seen this with my own eyes. Swamiji blessed Great Master. After a little while, Great Master says, "Swamiji, isn't it a pity that so many Swamis, so many yogis, yogeshwars, are all caught up in these six chakras below the eyes? None of them are aware of the chakras of awareness that lie behind. They don't know about the 18 chakras. Swamiji looks at him, "Master, what are these 18 chakras? I never heard of them before." He said, "Haven't you heard that these are the six chakras of Pinda, which means the body, physical body? Then there are chakras of Anda, which are the astral body. Then chakra of Brahmanda, and the chakra finally of Sachkhanda. Haven't you heard of them? The 18 chakras in us, in the human body." "Master, I must confess, I have never heard of these 18 chakras before. And will you please explain in little more detail what these chakras are?" Great Master said, "You know, it'll take a lot of time to go into all these things. But if you like, I can explain them to you. If you come to my dera for a little while, and then I will explain to you." And there the matter ended. They had their lunch. They went away. The Swami next day called my uncle. "I could not sleep all night. I am wondering where the 18 chakras are." And he told his followers, he had a great following in Karachi. He told his followers, "I am winding up my ashram. And I am going to Punjab to the Dera Bias, where this great master came into their house. And he talked of 18 chakras. I have to go and understand where these 18 chakras are. And what do they stand for? I have never heard of them." So he wound up his whole business there. And he came to the Dera. And of course, he said to his disciples, if you want to come, you can also come. Some of them followed, some did not go. It was too far along a distance. Then he, Swami, came. Great Master ordered, Swamiji should be put in the very best guest house, royal guest house, meant for two very important VVIPs who sometimes come to the Dera to see him. He should be housed in the best place. There should be attendants attending on him 24/7. And he should be, when I give a discourse, he should sit next to me on the stage. And he should be fed well. And he should be taken best care of. And he should be given the right to see me 24/7 whenever he wants to see me. Nobody should obstruct his way to see me. These instructions were issued. Swamiji was informed, you are a very special person. Great Master never given this kind of privilege to anybody. So you, Swamiji was very happy. And he held on to his scarf or something. And then he was put in the best place, given high VIP treatment. He could go anywhere. He tried to test out if it is really true that I can see the Master whenever I like. At 12:30 at night, middle of the night, he wakes up and goes. The attendants are there. I want to see the Master. Yes, sir. Yes, Swamiji. Open the door. Up, wake up, Great Master. Swamiji has come to see me. Yes, let him come. He says, really, I have this privilege to see him at any time. So he was very happy. Then, when the Master was giving a discourse, he sat next to him. And Great Master discoursed, how these Swamis and Yogis, they're so caught up in this energy centers. They've forgotten what truth is. They've forgotten the truth about their own true home. This is not our home. It's as foreign to us as this whole world we are trying to escape from. These chakras lead us nowhere. And this man was looking like this at him. After a couple of days, he said, Master, I have a little problem. And Great Master said, yes, Swamiji, what is your problem? He says, when you talk, I listen so attentively. I have to keep my head turned like this. I've got a pain in my neck. Great Master said, I also noticed that. No, Swamiji, I think it is good if you sit in front. So from the stage, Swamiji went down on the floor. But he was given a nice chair to look up. Then as the Master disclosed, after 2-3 days, Swamiji says, Master, I have a little problem. Yes, Swamiji, what is the problem now? Master, when you sit up on the high stage and I am down, I look like this, and now I got a pain in my neck. Great Master said, I also noticed that. Yes, put his chair about 20 paces behind those people. So there the chair moves behind there. After a few days, he said, Master, I have a little problem. Swamiji, what is the problem now? Now the problem is, when I sit on a chair, people behind me can't have your darshan. I feel very guilty. Great Master says, I also noticed that. Remove the chair. Let him sit like ordinary people. Ultimately, after a few weeks, Swamiji was like one of us, waiting in line to see the Master. The Master gave him a little place to run his Ayurvedic thing. And in those days, I was practicing homeopathic medicines, and he was practicing Ayurveda. So he gave us two places next to each other. So sometimes we would visit each other. One day I was sitting with the Swamiji. He said, your Master, great diplomat. He treated me like a VVIP. If I had known I had going to be treated like this today, what I'm being treated like, I would have gone away on day one. I would have gone back. This is no place where I'm being treated like that, being a Swami. And gradually he has put me down on the ground and brought me at the level where I belong. But he has caught me with love and I cannot run anywhere. His love has trapped me. I can go nowhere. I said, that is the secret of these people. Their secret is not their teaching. Their secret is not even their knowledge. Their secret is the love with which they pull us. And as you will stay longer, he says, even in these few weeks, I have seen what is drawing people to him is not his teaching, but his love. His love pulls us. And we are trapped. We can't go anywhere. I can go nowhere now. And then, of course, he made great progress too. He was a great Swami. But I am only giving you an idea how masters can deal with people in such strange ways that sometimes we don't understand it. Because they are not dealing with what we think they are dealing with. We think they are teachers come to teach us a spiritual way of meditating. They don't care for meditation. They don't care for the things we think are the most important things. They think the only thing that can pull us beyond the mind is unconditional love which comes from beyond the mind. They are sitting with us with that unconditional love coming directly from our source, coming directly from our true home, our Satchkhand.